All right, let's try this again. I'm frozen up on the internet. So Control Alt Delete, Task Manager, Applications. I'm gonna close this because I don't know what's going on with the internet. Oh, there it is. Yeah, I'm like frozen up. All right, Task Manager. I'm just going to go to Process, right click, End Process Tree, end all that junk. Got Premiere. Premiere can be closed. Let me see what I got up. Skip all that. I'm gonna close this for now. Sure, I'll save it, even though there's nothing there. Okay, here we are. Cancel. So we're not able to get the photo that we need. The photo that we need is Sarah Sanders images. I wanted this one, but maybe we'll just have to settle for something else. This one? Let's try this one. Right click, save image as. There we go, we get a JPEG. Go right to the desktop, save it. Or this one. Look through a few more. Talking about being thrown out. Really, the one I wanted is the one I couldn't get. This one. How do I get this picture? Highlight it, right click it, save image as. No. Right click it, open link. New tab, copy, save link as, search Google for image, or inspect, Control F, JPG, forget that. Forget that. Could be an easier way. Right click, copy image, go into Photoshop, file open, new is fine, paste, Control V. Oh, look at that, bananas. Okay, now what I could do is save as, and we'll just make it a JPEG and name it Sarah. We'll put it right on the desktop for now. Save it full quality. Okay, good. Now what we can do is we can open up, we can close this for now. We could erase the trash. We can go into, what was I going to get? Oh, okay, we're going to go into my images. And one of the later videos I did, I know, was the Trinity, so I'll just find that project. I'll open up that previous project because it's already the thumbnail size. And then over here, close that. I don't need her. So now I have my thumbnail size, also has my logo in it, which my logo looks a little weird there on the edge. It's interesting, I didn't notice that before. Is that in my channel logo? It must be right there. No, it's not actually.
That foolish hawk was dark.
Interesting. Okay, so it's not there. Why is it there here? How is it here now? Very bizarre. Maybe it's got a stroke. Take the stroke off. There you go. Okay, so that means if I go to my photos, my images, and type in Trinity. Oh, I spelled it wrong. Trinity. And I checked that photo. It looks good. Okay. Alright, so I'm going to move on to, I'm going to actually click File, Save. I'm going to save that, and then what I'm actually going to do is, I'm going to go File, Save As, and the title of my video is right here, Political Discrimination. Already 40 views? I just posted this. 48 views. Okay, grab this, copy. Control C, 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 C. Okay, I'm going to come over here. I'm going to name it that and click Save. Click OK. And what it's going to do here is resaved it as a different project. I'm going to shrink that again. I'm going to pull in my Sarah girl, which she showed up behind a gold layer here. So actually bring her forward. Okay, we could delete the background. We can delete the saturation, the curves, we could delete the texture. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to grab her with this tool and click Control T, and it's going to hold, I'm holding Shift and dragging the corner. Okay, why is she behind stuff here? We need to put her in the front. Click Enter. She's in the front. She's in the front. I'm confused. I'm going to delete this gold layer. And then what? Here's my name. Here's my symbol. Okay, that's fine. I'm going to grab her again. Oh, okay. So she didn't paste in fully. All right, let's delete her for a second and pull her back in from scratch. That's not the one we wanted. This is the one we wanted. There we go. I knew something was weird. Okay, now when this comes in, it's already highlighted. So I'm gonna hold Shift and drag the corners right there. This right here is I'm holding Control and pressing minus to zoom out or plus to zoom in. I'm gonna open this window bigger. Okay, so I'm gonna drag this in place and then I'm gonna hold Shift and drag out the edges right about there. I'm going to let go and I'm going to click Enter. And there we have it. Very nice already. Look at that. Look at that. Beautiful. So the TAC TIMES logo has, okay. You see stuff, you see that line right there. But when you zoom in, you don't see it. So I wonder what's on there. A drop shadow. Let's take that off and see if it does it. Oh, it's still there. It's interesting. Alright, so what I'll have to do is grab this logo like this, zoom in a little bit, Control plus, and grab this tool, and then I'm going to drag my oh, I'm dragging the whole logo, never mind. Alright, what I'm going to do is take this layer mask, right click it, delete the layer mask. There we go. This is why that logo had a line around it, because this is what the actual logo has, a white box around it. So I'm going to actually do is I'm going to delete that. I'm going to come over to my images and type in TAC TIMES logo. I have all these options here. This one's pretty cool. It's transparent PNG. So really all I have is that transparent one, TAC TIMES. Maybe PNG. So I have this option. This one's transparent. I'm going to go with let's go with this one. Drag it in. Alright, it's small, so I'm going to hold Shift, make it nice and big, and slap it in the upper left corner. That's a little too big. Shrink it. Upper left corner, lower left corner, or upper right corner. I would not put it down here because down here is where you're going to have the video length showing. And so anything that you put down there, whether it be someone's face or a logo, is going to get covered. Over here is nice because it doesn't get in her way of her hair. Over here there's a little more space. So I'm going to hit enter and then zoom out a little bit. And it's almost ready there. Let's see if we can show more at the top of her head. No, her head's cut off. Okay. All right. So we have the logo in. I'm going to click Control S to save our progress on this. I'm going to actually delete these. I don't need them anymore. And I can even empty the recycling bin. And this is not going to affect what I'm working at on here. What I'm going to do is open bigger, zoom in a little more. I'm going to put, I'm on her face here, her file. Go to layer, select, no, filter, sharpen, unsharp mask. And then I'm going to raise it up to about, like, let's just say 100. And then I'll put this down to about, actually, let's put this to 3, and then we'll turn it off and on. So it's got too much artifacts, which means it's getting, it's too, the radius is too low. It's affecting, wait, am I right or wrong? Here, let's try a high sharpening, a low radius. Off, on. Well, everything's a lot sharper, and plus this is going to be shrunk down, but let's just say, even if we're looking at it here, off, on, off, on. It's a little much. We can pull it back. Okay, off, on, off, on. If you look at the eyes, you can see off, on, the glow, the glare in the eyes. Okay, we can accept that, and then we can even go again, filter, unsharp, mask, again, and then here we can raise up to like 10 or so, and then we can even pull back on the amount and try that off, on, off, on. It's popping a little more contrast, on, off, on. Once again, if you look at the eyes or the nose or focus on the detail, the herpes on her upper lip, up, on, off, okay. And while we're at it, we could even fix that herpes. We can just take this, where is the tool? There it is, the clone stamp tool, right? Clone stamp, it's not gonna let me do it because this layer looks like this. It needs to be rasterized, so I'm going to right click, rasterize layer, and now it gives me this, and I can shrink the size of it, and there are shortcuts for this stuff. Here we go. I'm going to hold Alt, and I want to click somewhere over here, maybe other side of her lip. Oh, see, when I hold Alt, I need to raise the size of this tool a little smaller than that, maybe here. Alt, grab right here about-ish, and then go like that, right, left click on it, and 1, 2, 3, herpes is gone. There's a little tip for you. Okay, all right, next up we have, we want to bring in over here a hue, and actually let's pull in the curves first. In the curves, we just want to pop the brights out and possibly darken the lows a little bit, but not so much. And so if you turn it off here, you can see the difference: on, off, on, off. Sometimes if you want to grab this and drag it all the way to the corner and let go, it'll pop off, it'll reset. So you can just pop the, that's a little much, pop the mids there, and then crunch blacks a little bit, a little more maybe. And then this is off, on, actually this is a little much. This is a little much. All right, back it out. I'm just gonna boost a little bit of the mids to bring some brights into the shot. There we go. Off, on. So now what happened is we lost a little saturation, so we'll come, and I put this on because the picture just looks better in most cases when it's illuminated, brighter, and you could see what there is. But in doing this, it gets a little washed out. So let's add the hue and saturation, and let's see what happens if we just bring some saturation in a little bit. Might be a little much. Just brought it up like plus 9, plus 10, plus 8. And then you can actually click it off and then on. Just filled in a little bit of the color, a tiny bit. That's fine. I think we're good. I don't think we need anything more than that, really. Take off saturation. I almost like it better without the saturation. Maybe because the skin tone's off. You can play with the hue a little bit. Too red, make it look like a demon or a Martian. Or you could just put that back about there-ish. Plus 3. Slightly more bluish tint. You could pop in a little more brights. Plus 2. Actually, I put a minus 2. Never mind. And I think that's it. I think that's all we really need. So, if we were to pull that photo back up to the front, that's the old one. That's the new one. Zoom in. That's the old. That's the new. Old. The new. So it's a little brighter. Oh, it's at this. Actually, this is not the old. I'm sorry. That's not the old because that's after we sharpened it. So it's really not. There's actually much more of a difference here. Anyway, we deleted the old one, so we don't have the comparison. But there we go. We're good. What I'm going to do is file, save. And then I'm going to go to file, save as. So I saved it already as a Photoshop document, but I'm going to make it a JPEG. And well, it already has the same name on it. I'm going to save, and then we need to keep this under 2 megabytes for YouTube thumbnail, so drop this a little bit. It's got 1.5, that's fine. We're going to click OK. And then we're going to pull back into the video. Go to edit the video. Go to custom thumbnail. Let's type Sarah. And there it is. Click open. And it's going to take a minute to update this, but save the changes. Get your end screen annotations here. Do I have any? I don't have any, do I? So import from video. Let's import it. Let's start it off from like a feminist video or something. So we have Oprah Winfrey, political incorrectness. Let's preview it.
Why, we know that it is the last time.
This can be longer. This can come out to a this can come out further to here. We can make like a ladder. Yeah, there we go. It's all political related stuff, so we could save that. Click preview again.
Little children, it is the last time, and as ye have heard that an antichrist shall come, even now are there many antichrists, whereby we know that it is the last time.
Okay, so this is political, so we have Oprah, we have political incorrectness playlist. Benny Mardonis. I think we're fine with this stuff. We could have Antifa video. We can have uploads. We can have feminism video. And then, yeah, that should be fine. I think that should be fine. Or we can have, take off the Oprah and put Black Lives Matter and save all that. Test it out.
Little children, it is the last time, and as ye have heard that an antichrist shall...
Alright, so we're good. So come back to the video. Actually, let's go to the channel. Let me pause this intro that automatically plays. But you see, the thumbnail's already there. And see, this is the... Apparently the top or bottom left is your best spot, because as you hover over these... Watch later, okay. I don't recall that icon popping up there before, but... Well, there you have it. Thumbnail is there. All right, that should conclude our thumbnail session. Have yourself a nice life. Goodbye now.